Yeah. Uh-huh, you know what it is.
Black and gold, black and gold, black and gold, black and gold.
Yeah. Uh-huh, you know what it is.
Black and gold, black and gold, black and
gold. Gets to the 45. Left sideline, yeah. He's got a seam.
You know what it, what is. Everything we do it big. Yeah. Uh-huh, screaming that's nothing. When you play at the zoo, better stop.
Come one, come all, 2011 version of Mizzou football, getting ready to go to camp here in about 3 weeks. Chris, we're here dressed the part, obviously, and ready to talk about your Tigers in 2011.
I'm ready.
That was great. I love the hair, by the way.
Oh,
it's a good color for you.
Thanks, man.
We're coming off of your 10-2 season, three counting the bowl loss to Iowa. So 10 wins last year. Missouri returns almost every starter on offense,
right,
minus a couple. And on defense, this is one of the best defensive units Gary Pinkel's ever had. Deep. That has to count for something because in this magazine, guys, in Appalachian's magazine,
get it.
You have teams like Auburn, Arkansas, losing quarterbacks, but yet rated, you know, way higher than us. Missouri coming in barely ranked at 24th, I believe. And I think that the what Gary Pinkel has done, the way he's built depth on this team, the recruiting that's picked up, it is asinine to think that this team could finish fifth. Now, could it finish fifth? Yes, it could.
Yeah, absolutely.
James Franklin is a wild card.
He is a wild card, and those factors will always be there. But here's the exciting thing that everybody has to be looking forward to, has to be ready for, and that is the dynamic that he brings that's different than a pocket passer. You know, his ability to scramble outside the pocket and make plays with his legs. And with the wide receiving core that we have coming back, I mean, my God, you got Jarrell Jackson, TJ Moe, Wes Kemp. I mean,
what you don't have, unfortunately, is a proven game breaker at that position.
Right.
You have guys, you know, TJ Moe, one of the best possession receivers. Michael Agnew at tight end.
Yeah, and Agnew's the X factor.
But you don't have anybody to stretch the field yet. You don't have a Jeremy Maclin or Denario. That's what this offense missed last year. And what you hope is that somebody from the camp of, you know, Bud Sasser, Marcus Lucas, or Jimmy Hunt can step up and be that kind of player this year. That's what Missouri needs at the wide receiver position, because I think it's going to be a little more run-oriented this year, as Coach Yost has indicated.
With that being said, who is a guy that could be one of those guys that could maybe even have a breakout year that we don't even know about yet in your head?
I'll tell you a guy that played a little bit last year as a true freshman, which was four-star recruit Marcus Lucas from Liberty High School in Kansas City. He played last year a little bit at wide receiver. It's a loaded position, so to say he got some playing time was very key for him last year. Coming into this year, he's going to have to beat some people out. He's going to have to beat out a Wes Kemp to get that playing time. But Lucas is a tall, you know, fast receiver with good hands, strong, runs good routes. He's going to be a major factor in this offense, and really could be the TJ Moe this year, because, you know, coming into last year, TJ Moe only had two or three career receptions and had 92 last year. I have a question for you. I'm pulling this out of our mailbag.
Oh, baby, I like the mailbag.
This is an important one. It's on everybody's mind. Now, Sheldon Richardson. One, is he going to be here? And two, is he going to be a factor? Because they say he's going to get academically qualified and he should be here on August 3rd when camp starts. But is he going to be here, and is he going to, you know, be a factor up front? Because the depth is so good up front for Missouri.
Well, you know, I think after everything that the coaching staff, the fans have gone through with this guy, him going to JUCO, him having to get academically eligible, and all this
committing
stuff.
Committing to USC.
The tools are there for the guy. I mean, there's no doubt about it. The USC thing's another one that bothered me. But the tools are there for the guy. I've watched a guy, you know, play. Now, this was 2 years ago when I watched him play, but he looked like a guy that could definitely come in and be, I'm not going to go so far as to say an Ndamukong Suh type player, but a guy that could definitely get some good penetration for you.
He's
a five-star recruit,
formally,
for God's sake. Can we get him and see what he can do?
One thing that that really needs to be brought up here is that Missouri has not only a veteran team, Chris, but a veteran offensive line.
Yes.
You're talking about Elvis Fisher and Dan Hogue at your tackle positions. Obviously, you have to replace Tim Barnes in the middle, but you Austin Webbles, Jason Palmgren.
And those, it just drives
those,
going.
Those type of,
Jack Miners backing them up.
Yes.
I mean,
this line is going to be one of the best Missouri's ever had. Does that feed the run game this year?
Yes, I think that is going to be something that we haven't had in the past. You're going to have a running game now. I mean, there's nothing in my body that tells me that Gary Pinkel doesn't already know that and that they haven't been preparing for that.
This is the toughest schedule it's played. You're talking out of the gate, if you look at the schedule, five ranked teams.
That fourth
Arizona
game.
State on the road is game two.
Game two.
And then you're opening at Oklahoma, guys. That's your first conference
game. That's
your
first big 12 game.
With that being said, I'm going to go ahead right now and predict Missouri's record for 2011. We both are. Put this on record because, you know, we want to come back and look at this and say, oh my gosh, we were wrong, or oh my gosh, we were right.
Yes.
I think Missouri's going to be 9-3 this year.
I think it's very fair.
I think your losses are going to be, I'm going to go ahead and say Arizona State. I'm going to say that we lose that game.
It's a game I'm worried about. I'd be lying if I wasn't, and it's just for the simple fact it's not a team that we play.
It's just, it's one of those games. We haven't lost a non-conference game since 2005, and I think Oklahoma and I think A&M, those two games on the road will be your losses. And I think if we go 9-3 and those are our losses, that means you're going to beat Oklahoma State.
Yes.
You're going to win the games you're supposed to. And, you know, I think 9-3 would be a very good season.
Solid season.
I think 8-4 and 7-5 is possible if we lose.
It's very possible.
Off the bat. But 10-2 and 11-1 is also possible
with
this team Pinkel has built. So,
you know,
what is your record? Give it to us and give it to me straight.
Okay.
I ask only out of respect, give it to me straight because I can handle it.
Well,
our fans can handle
let
it.
Let me tell you, I've got a lot of people that are looking at me funny because of how high I am on the Tigers this year. And it's not just because I'm a fan. I legitimately think the way that Gary Pinkel has built this team and these guys, there is a lot of talent on this football team that's gone unrecognized. And believe it or not, I feel that a 10-2 season is very, very possible. And
who are the losses?
Obviously it's going to be a nightmare going into Oklahoma after beating them last year. The revenge that they're going to want to get after
Bob Stoops barking, not disrespect card. You know that'll be
We're going to have that going on. They're going to be playing for Austin Box this year, who, by the way, terrible loss for them, and we're sorry for his family. That is going to be tough going into that stadium.
Yeah.
And the Boomer Schooner is going to be running. And my buddy Cecil's going to be yelling. And, you know, the whole thing about it is, folks, I think that will be a loss. And I believe we'll beat Arizona State. I believe it'll be a close game, but I think that's a game we get through. My second loss, actually, it comes a little bit later in the season, and it's going to be another surprise.
We always have one.
You know, I have this terrible feeling about this season with going in to Texas A&M, and I say it's a surprise, but the reason I feel it's a surprise is because I feel like that's a game we should win after the way we played last year.
Having to go there 2 years in a row
there. Yes.
Is tough. Okay.
But you know, on the positive note on all this, is I've got us beating Texas at home. You know why? Because I pray that is going to be the Gold Rush game. Don't know. They may have already determined it. But you know what? That, to me, is going to be the Oklahoma game from last year. That's going to be the game that all the fans come out to. If we got a good record going into it, I hope that it's going to be a nationally televised game.
So you think for Texas that Missouri, and I agree with you on this,
and I'm
needs
not
to
just
bring
saying,
out the big guns and
yes.
the gold uniforms.
All
is
gold.
It time?
All gold.
All gold, is it time?
You know why? We be trendsetting, son.
Hey, all you fuddy-duddies out there that don't want to see the all gold uniforms or any variation, it's time to bust them out.
Bust them out.
Chris, I've already bought us tickets to the Meineke Car Care Bowl. Are you saying that may not be one you want to attend?
Well, I definitely wouldn't cancel those reservations just yet, but let me tell you what. We have got to break into the BCS at some point.
Yeah.
I mean, this is ridiculous. Missouri is now starting to be a school that is constantly winning. One of these years, it's going to happen. Why not this year? Why do we always got to say it? Next year, we'll be ready. Why not this year? Cam Newton and Auburn didn't know they were going to do it. It's happened before.
I don't think they've won two conference games in 2 years. That's not bad for a basketball school.
You know what cracks me up? I listen to Bob Fesco on 610 Sports in the morning. I don't like him at all, really.
I hate him. I hate you, Bob Fesco.
I think that's a fair thing.
So come on our show.
Yeah, exactly. And I got to be honest, I think I really hate him too. I don't really generally hate people, but he's so one-sided in everything that he says. He cuts people off that make a good point against him, and the guy is so staunch Kansas, it makes me sick. You come out on your radio show and you say that, you know, you guys have a better recruiting class. We only had limited scholarships this year, right?
In 2011, for this season, we were down to 15.
Okay.
Which is what brought our star level down a little bit. We had still a four-star in Sheldon.
And the guys that he's talking about that they're recruiting, those are the same kind of guys we've got as backups, Bob.
They had Brock Berglund, a three-star quarterback from Colorado, that was ran off the team at the spring game, and he's not going to make it. Chris, moving on, let's talk about the fact that, you know, the Big 12 this year is now the Big 12 minus two. There's 10 teams. Who wins it? I say Oklahoma. I think everybody pretty much agrees with that. You think Oklahoma State, Texas A&M, or Missouri, or even Texas has a chance?
You know, I think the top two teams in the Big 12 this year is going to be Oklahoma and Oklahoma State. The only reason I see Oklahoma winning this thing, it's not because of Landry Jones. I still am not sold on the guy. He makes a lot of mistakes. If he goes down, Oklahoma then maybe have a tough time, because I got to be honest, I look for Missouri to be second or third. Call me crazy.
Chris, you know, one thing that people ask me about a lot is this linebacker group from Missouri. We're talking about, Luke Lambert getting a red shirt season.
Yes.
A medical hardship to come back. Will Ebner back from injury, we talked about that before. But you're talking about Xavier Gooden and Andrew Wilson and just an absolute host of Tiger linebackers. Is this one of the best linebacking crews we've ever had here?
You know, I think it's definitely got to rank up there. I mean, the guys that are there are all solid players. They're all hitters, tacklers. I mean, these guys are ball hawks. I'm very, as you know, on the show here, we're very big on Will Ebner there in the middle. Moving outside of Will Ebner, Xavier Gooden, folks. My God, this guy, to me, this guy's an NFL guy.
He's a Buck Kiss Award.
Exactly. He's already a candidate. This guy, I mean, you see him in person, and you talk about a guy that you would build a sculpture of.
And what about the fact that you have, guys like Donovan Bonner, who's been hurt but is going to be a factor? Darwin Ruiz, who I absolutely love. He is an absolute stud.
Yes.
He's got, you know, Sean Witherspoon's number, looks a little bit like Spoon. What about this, Chris? As a walk-on, Derek Thomas's son is on the squad.
I love it regardless what happens with him, because obviously if you live in the state of Missouri, you're probably a Chiefs fan. And if you're a Chiefs fan, you obviously know who Derek Thomas is, a legend of the sport. And his son, if he is able even to get in some games and make some plays, I tell you what, it's a great story outside of everything else. And I wish the kid the absolute best. I'm gonna end it by saying out these names. You tell me one player, if you disagree, that he could not be a potential star. Okay? I'm going to go run through them real quick here. Brad Madison, Dominique Hamilton, Terrell Rosano, we've got Jaquie Smith, Will Ebner, Andrew Wilson, you know, we've got Xavier Gooden, Kip Edwards, E.J. Gaines, Kenji Jackson, Tavon Bolden.
Yes.
Okay.
The answer to that is yes. Who's ready for some football, M.I.Z.?
Okay, everyone, Amy, this is my sister, Amy. Amy, welcome to the Sports Horn. You are the camera lady, so you've obviously been here. Tell me who the hottest Missouri Tiger is on that football team.
Oh, really? What kind of a question is that?
I already know who my wife thinks. She's a big fan of her, since she's seen him in that picture. So, this guy's got, he's almost got the figure, I guess.
T.J. Moe?
Yeah. Okay. I think they know it. but I didn't used to.
Okay, so that's an ex-Tiger.
Okay,
name is a current
Tiger.
Jimbo it is. Way to go, TJ.
Way to go.